And it goes downhill from there, unfortunately.
Yep.
It happens, man. It happens. Oh, and against like something like Donkey Kong, one interaction is really going to help him out. So now we got It's Time facing off against Matadork. DK versus Banjo. I believe in you. Don't doubt yourself.
All right, as we get this grand final started, how do you feel about Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 being the next tournament here in this next Sunday?
I mean, it's Marvel, baby.
It's Marvel time.
I mean, it's great. I'm glad to see that Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 is making its return over here to the Bakersfield Esports Center. I don't know if I'll be able to participate or even be able to come by, but I'm glad to see it here. I'm always glad to see it here. I'm always glad to just kind of see more fighting games here in Bakersfield, and seeing that the Bakersfield Esports Center is doing tournaments on Sundays, which makes it a lot easier for me to enter and enjoy.
Well, I'm definitely going to be here. I'm going to commentate, or maybe I'll just try it myself. If some people don't show up, we'll come by and enjoy some Just Marvel 3. You love to see it.
Yep. So, Matadork getting ready. I'm curious to see where they're going to start off, and I'm curious to see if he even wants to touch DK. Banjo has such a strong zoning game against DK, and yes, you have the fact that DK is a heavier character. He can survive a lot of Banjo stuff. Banjo has side B that just kind of goes yeet.
Goodbye.
Yeah, so this is going to be kind of scary.
The hero, he said he wants the bad PS2.
Yeah. He's going to get rid of that right off the back. Ooh, Jungle Japes?
Banned! That's banned!
Look, I say we legalize WarioWare. I want to die at 30% as Pichu.
You want to die just... You wanted to be gone.
WarioWare, let's go!
You wanted to be gone.
Oh, yeah, it happens, man.
As you see here...
where they want to go.
Our upcoming events... Next week, we have Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, and then a little down the road in May, we will have Bok Anime, and we will have another Smash event there on May 21st and 22nd.
It'll actually be Smash back-to-back, if you really think about it, because next week is Marvel 3. The week after that is Smash again. The week after that is Bok Anime Smash. So literally, it's just back-to-back Smash events. It's great. I love it. Most likely, we'll not be able to participate in the Bok Anime event, but I will be here for the May 15th event, and hope to support as much as I can.
Hell yeah. All right. We can't wait for that, and we got to thank our sponsors, our nice and
I think we got a decision. We're going sponsors. To FD.
Yeah.
The G Fuel sponsor, the red ooze feels good, man. All right. So they're going to FD, and they're picking their music. Okay. Let's see. Where are they going? The Fire Emblem music? Which one? From...
There's 44 songs.
Lost in Thoughts All Alone? Let's go. That's just the rhythm version. You want the number 30. That's the English dub. I want the Japanese. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, that should be it. Yeah, I love. I'm actually one of the few people who can say I like Fire Emblem Fates. Yep. See, I will be completely honest. Fire Emblem Fates as a game. It's a game, that's for sure. But I will give it this. I love its characters. I love its music. And Corrin needs shoes on. So here we go. Game one on FD with Lost in Thoughts All Alone on soundtrack. Here we go. Banjo versus DK.
How is Corrin supposed to make his dragon thing off his feet if he has shoes on?
No. So here we go, Matador taking a nice lead over It's Time. But It's Time already starting the zoning game now. He's got him spaced out. It's gonna be rough for DK to approach now. He has to deal with his zoning, and it's gonna be so rough. Oh, gets the grab. He's throwing him out.
Nice tech.
Oh, good bear, but he got the tech. Good stuff coming out from It's Time. Now It's Time has him off stage, and Banjo's just kind of, wow, what a call out from Matador. Good stuff.
You always got to be aware of the armor.
That armor is so good for DK. And oh, he tried to get a little bit of that cheese to to get that Banjo down, because Banjo's recovery can be a little bit awkward going up. His horizontal is good, or somewhat good, because he has, you know, Wonder Wing, but his vertical is definitely awkward. Unfortunately, now he's trapped in these in a chain grab-like situation. This isn't Melee or Brawl, but he's still going to get somewhat chain grab with good decisions.
Take a drink for every time he misses down throw up tilt. Come on. Just give him more consistency. God, the up tilt is so unfortunate. It's just like...
It happens, man.
No, I've seen, like, at least maybe from one game, he always misses down throw up tilt. He goes for it every time. He will miss it.
But it's because he can't just mash it immediately, from my understanding. Again, right. You have to kind of, like, move forward a little bit, or you have to read the jump.
Right.
I like to kind of mix it up and actually just kind of stay planted to the ground, and then the Banjo player kind of like freaks out a little bit because they're not expecting it. But if I'm it's time, I always see that as an opportunity to combo rather than just get an easy up tilt or an easy up smash, because it might not always work. Kind of mix it up, if you will. Make it a 50-50. Since it doesn't always work. But right now, It's Time has a whole stock behind. Matador has the lead. He's throwing out those down tilts right now. Matador able to kind of stay away.
Wonder Wing for position.
The wrong way.
Wing for position. That's what that was. We go step back to neutral.
Oh, goes for the far Wonder Wing, wanting to get that kill. Luckily, DK. He's a big boy. He doesn't mind. Gets the down smash. There you go. Good stuff coming out from this time. Go. Now we're basically at almost an even game. It's Gary for Alpha, for Matador right now. I want to keep calling him Alpha for some reason.
Alpha took him on a nice third. Well, we're seeing who's going to take first and who's going to take second here.
Yep, and right now, Matador does have to technically reset the bracket. What I mean by this is that if you are in a Smash tournament, there are two brackets, if you will. A winner's bracket and a loser's bracket. Everyone starts off in winner's bracket. When you lose one match, you drop down to losers. Grand finals is technically the person who's won all the way to winner's bracket, and then the person who's won all the way up to loser's bracket. However, for the loser to win this tournament, he has to knock the winner from the winner's bracket in grand finals to now the loser's bracket. That means he has to take three matches off him and hits the spike down. Good stuff from Matador. Great decision.
Good game one game for him.
But yep.
Alright, let me just...
I think I just heard confirmation. They're going back to FD with the same music. Let's go.
No music counter pick? Oh, this is gonna be rough.
No, I reminded them. They heard it. What are they going for now? Huh. Do we go with the Sonic music? Do we go with the banjo, the bayonetta?
The miscellaneous?
The miscellaneous. Oh, Wii Sports music. We want that boxing music.
Oh my god. Speaking of Wii Sports music, the new Wii Sports is out now.
Which one are you looking for? Oh, I don't think they have. You have to get it as DLC. Do we not have Megalovania? I'm bringing my Switch next time.
Oh my goodness.
That's okay.
Missed opportunity, I guess.
Yep. Captain Falcon. Are you? Excuse me. It's literally the same artist as Sonic. But Escape from the City. Okay, I'll let it rock. I'm gonna take away the DJ privileges soon, and I'm gonna let you guys pick your own music.
You can't take away my privileges, I'll just be mama then.
I'm gonna take the Joy-Cons and hold them and be like, okay, you guys can't start until I press start.
As they have their own controllers that aren't Joy-Cons in their hands.
Exactly. I'm the judge here now. So right now, Matador putting its time right off the stage. I'm really curious to see why they went back to FD.
It wasn't too bad. It was very, very close.
It was, but I feel like Banjo could take advantage of some platformers while DK would definitely struggle with. Oh my gosh,
nice
what
smash.
A read coming from Matador. Just spiking poor Banjo straight down into the ground. Great decision from It's Time to kind of stay away. Matador was looking for that quick recovery. and now we're back. It's definitely a scary situation for its time right now. If he approaches and he makes a wrong decision, DK's gonna just yeet the man. He's gonna yeet that poor bear.
It's a bear versus a monkey. Just a regular Animal Planet like commentary. The bear is throwing its eggs to protect its young, and the bird is assisting with its armor for some reason.
And the monkey just smacked the crud out of that bear and sent it flying into the blast zone. Majestic.
Absolutely marvelous. And this has been David Attenborough.
And now we have... And now, right now, its time is just in such a strange spot. He has a life about 40... He has 44% behind Matador, and it's just so awkward. Oh, the donkey punch! Matador already now in the lead with a whole stock and with 30%, with only 30% off of it. 44 now. Its time has to get either a quick, easy kill right here, or he's going to be in a very awkward spot dealing with enraged DK.
I love and that. I love
that. DK's hitbox just said, I'm going to swing all the way back. Don't worry about it.
Yeah. I also love that little interaction of just a cargo throw, up throw into back air, and then try to read with the down air. I love to see that. If that worked, that would have been great. What?
I think he was trying to dodge into the stage. I can't quite tell, but it happens. It's an accident. Unfortunately, he just couldn't recover in time. Matadork kind of scared him. But Matadork already now on a potential bracket reset. I think it can happen. And where are they going to go? PS2? Are we going to hear some Cynthia music?
Oh, no, new music, Vic.
That's okay. That's okay. Can I help you? What's up? Yo. Alright. So, it's time down 0-2 right now against Matador. Matador on the crypts of bracket reset, and they are playing on PS2. The gentleman's PS2 stage, if you will.
The starter of starters.
The true starting stage. And right now, Matador already getting a small lead, and now it's back to its time's lead. Spin. Oh,
Hefty
little
punish.
Wonder Wing.
Hefty
and
punish.
He blocked the Donkey Punch, forcing Matador to spend his resource. And now they're back into sort of a very zoning game. He's shooting his gun. There's going to be a huge... I think he missed a little bit of a punish there, but that's okay. He was going for a pretty big combo, and I think it would have benefited Matador really well.
Ooh, nice up air back on stage.
And
yeah.
Up airs.
Just using his head.
I don't want to use my head!
Back throw
off the stage. Oh, almost got hit by the egg, and unfortunately DK's recovery... The hurt box for DK's up B makes no sense. Because unfortunately that little piece of his head, you know, that little curve part? Yeah, that's technically part of the hurt box.
Whoa!
Oh,
What is that? That was a great play, whatever it was.
It was just a really good edge guard, taking advantage of DK's recovery. He only can go horizontal and just got a good punish off it, preventing DK from doing anything off stage. Now Matador has, It's Time has has all the momentum right now. This matchup is very much just in a scary spot for DK. One good decision, it's game over. Now Matador can bring it back because DK enraged is scary. But Banjo doesn't really mind, you know, enraged characters because, well, he hits like a truck.
Right.
So there we go. Matador now only down one stock. He can take this back. There is possible for Matador to take this back. It's just it's going to be a very long and tedious moment for right now.
Which is apparently what you want to see. You want to see long, tedious timeouts.
Only in certain situations. And the good read coming out with that Wonder Wing. And I'm surprised he didn't get that grab right there. Hitting him with that almost dock-like fair, and then going smack with Kazooie. Kazooie said,
all right. It's time taking his first game of this first Grand Finals. Now we move on to the next one.
They're playing Crankies over there.
At least we can join friendly, so we'll be there soon once this is all said and done.
I actually did bring some of my cards around this time.
The one time I don't.
Normally, there's always a casual Yu-Gi-Oh! Meetup when we after Smash, but it looks like it's not going to happen. All right, what are we playing now? Seven Rings in hand? That's not the good version of his world. They don't have it in this game. They don't use that version. That's Zebra Head version. This is the... Yeah. Yeah, they don't... Zebra Head's like a legit band, so they're not going to pay for that. Huh? What's there? So, when it comes to the copyright, technically, they own part of it. Because it's their voice. They could do the Crush 40 version, but even that version is not that good. If I have a choice on the Sonic music, Lights, Camera, Action from Sonic Mania. That's some good stuff right there.
Oh, it's from Sonic Mania. Oh my goodness.
Okay, that's legit. I'll take it. Wait, I don't see Link.
All right, game number four.
Matador versus It's Time, game four. Matador with the lead with a potential record reset. They're back to Final Destination. And right now, Matador already has a good, strong life lead, keeping him trapped against the wall, but It's Time almost getting close to tying it up. It's basically a very even game right now. But now It's Time at a nice 40% while Matador kind of keeping him out. He doesn't have to approach right now. He really doesn't. Now he has to approach. 28% versus 43%. It's trapping him with that grenade was nice. I wish he would have kept him blocking, keeping him stuck there. Nice little option select coming from It's Time. He left the grenade there to kind of
cover the Matador
wind,
yeah.
And prevent, you know, getting punished. Ooh, and almost, and trying to two frame Matador right there. It's Time. It can work. It's just, it's when DK is going a little is low on recovery. So, ooh, the down smash and Matador living because he's monkey.
I would have probably up smash instead of that, but I could see that punish on the B there.
I think it was just a little bit easier. You don't have to worry about DK kind of just getting hit out of it or SDIing out of it.
Right.
But I mean, I'm not a Banjo expert. It was It's Time's choice, and either way, he still got the stock, so it's all that matters for him. So It's Time right now with a nice little lead. Spin. Matador has to get this lead right now. Oh no.
Oh,
he went for the downtown. He said special delivery. And throwing the grenade down. Right now, It's Time has just such a nice little lead going against Matador. He's zoning him out. There's not much he can do. He has to deal with his zoning, and it's just fairly rough. Armor can only do so much. You have to, one, he's gonna have to take away the stock as fast as possible.
What was the read?
I guess the guaranteed throw. I don't know. That was a very interesting.
What is the mind game?
And we take those though. It's still a good idea.
Oh.
Very close for Matador right now. He can take this. I don't know why. In my head, I thought, oh, he has a grenade on him. He'll just explode out of his grab. Yeah, no, that doesn't work.
What am I thinking? Nope. Three.
Oh!
Two Wonder Wing left on this stock.
Only two?
Yep, there's only two now.
I could swear I've only seen like one Wonder Wing. Getting fared, but he's Donkey Kong. He will live out. Never mind.
Unfortunate side B right there.
The bird went, I'm a sniper now.
The snipes.
All right, we're moving on to game five. If Matador takes it, he resets the bracket.
You're right.
It's Time takes it, that's it. It's over.
Yep, and we declare It's Time the winner, but Matador, once again, he is fighting for his repeat win.
I say we give Matador to DK Rap. That will give him the power he needs right now. They're going to Northern Cave, playing One Winged Angel. Good choice. The stage is interesting in my book. And I think with DK, it's going to really help him. Oh!
Finally brings out the Mewtwo.
I think this is a really good choice coming for Matador. Mewtwo zoning definitely can keep Banjo away. Yes, he does still have to worry about dying early. He does have to worry about dying early now because of, you know, Wonder Wing. But Mewtwo can kind of throw Banjo around and stay away from him a lot more. Look at that. A nice 40% coming from Matador. He's charging up that neutral B. He's got his resource ready. Those projectiles, Mewtwo don't mind.
Right. Reflect.
I can hold up. Reflect. And Mewtwo actually does have something similar to DK, being that he has big disjointed hitboxes, so his moves have quite a bit of range on them.
Yep.
And throwing out that neutral B, ooh.
Oh,
that's an unfortunate part. He has to worry about that side B now more than ever, because side B will go through almost everything.
Yep, and you do get those nice mobility, a nice projectile, and the nice reflect with the Mewtwo, so you do trade off the survivability.
Oh, no.
What an unfortunate. That was also
that was a very interesting exchange off stage.
He just bonked himself on the head and was like, okay, I can't recover anymore. Ooh, that was right. Not taking it even on Mewtwo. Back throw?
And
not yet.
Back throw. Right now, Matador's gonna go all the way down. I'm Mewtwo, I have recovery. And getting that up smash would have done a nice bit of damage. Oh, oh wow, he called it out with the tail. That's kind of why it happens. The first up tilt missed, but luckily the second one hit. So it's time, got that stock. Right now, it's in an awkward spot though, because Matador doesn't have to approach. He has a nice little life lead going. It's time has to be the one to kind of do something right now. And it's really awkward for him because Banjo's pokes aren't exactly the most optimal.
Yeah.
They tend to have a bit of recovery for him, and Mewtwo's going to take advantage of it. Oh, the Wonder Wing putting Matador in such an awkward spot, but he's got Banjo back on mid stage. He's got a nice little life lead ahead of him. Gets the up tilt, sending him straight up. Oh, he tried to commit to a read, trying to get him to jump, but it's time to not fall for it. He's ready for it. The back throw, he wanted to go yeet.
Oh my good. All right, this is kind of a weird situation here, but we are racking up a little bit of damage with the Matador.
I saw that side beat grab its time, and then my heart just went, oh my gosh, he's going to do something so good right here. And unfortunately, he didn't get it, and that happens. Oh,
nice
no.
Call out.
Because
nice
Dewey. Oh, but the bear surprisingly did not kill. That was actually very shocking. Going for the far kill, that's okay.
Yep. Now he has one Wonder Wing left in this second stop. But 45% is a lot of percentage.
For Mewtwo, it is. It's so scary. But I think it's still possible for Matador to take this because Mewtwo does hit like a truck as well. So, I mean, I don't think it's impossible. The match is not over yet.
Ooh,
oh, my
that
gosh.
Ooh, the
snare.
But I'll throw this.
And I'm up.
Yep.
Whee! All right, this is still possible for Matador. Ooh. Those dash attacks are very strange to me. I get why they're being done, but
ooh.
It is still strange to me. Oh, this is so scary right there. Banjo's. Its time has shown that he's ready for that edge. He wants to punish people off the edge right there, and he's been doing it quite a bit throughout this tournament. So that's very scary in my book. Right now, Matador has to just take your time, be a little patient, look for your window. There's your window. There he goes. Matador got a nice little two-hit combo going. The grenade saving him. Ooh.
All right, we're down to four Wonder Wings.
Oh no. Oh.
Oh no.
Oh no.
What? Oh no.
To end the set. Oh no. It happens, man. Well, congratulations to It's Time taking it over Matador. That was a bummer. I think Matador almost took it. It was so great. The platform.
Yeah.
It happens, man. It happens. But good stuff to Matador. Great Mewtwo play. Great Donkey Kong play. That was so good. Congratulations to Matador on his second place. And then congratulations to It's Time taking it with Banjo and Kazooie. Good stuff.
Yep. And that has been Smash It Up number 9 at Baker City Solar Center. I hope to see you around for the next tournament and the next few Smash tournaments coming up here in May. This has been DJ Mama.
And I am Carnitas. And we'll see you all next time.
See you now.